Hey everybody, what's going on? Hope you guys are ready for the holidays. We're going to be playing DDAL. Sorry about that. We're going to be playing DDEX1 tonight, part 3. And it is Shadows Over the Moon Sea. We've got our patrons playing tonight. Thank you guys for joining us. Don't forget, tomorrow is the giveaway extravaganza. I've got two giveaway extravaganzas going on tomorrow, one for the patrons. That's going to be between 8 and probably 9 or so. And then I'll be back in the Twitch channel at about 10. So I got lots of stuff to give away, like every year. The exception is you guys have to pay for shipping. I've already bought all the books and all that stuff. Plus, a lot of people have donated things to the stream. Fantasy Grounds has donated some stuff, as well as Kobold Press. I think Limitless Adventures. Then I've got tons of Steam games. I've got some map packs from Grey Tales, Greg Taylor, which is Dungeon Arts. And then I also have a ton of Devonite token packs, so, and D&D books. So you guys be here, be square. I'm going to do some stuff for my subscribers, and then I'm going to do some stuff free for all. So hopefully just about everybody will at least get a Steam game or something like that. So, all right. So hope you guys are ready for the holidays. Merry Christmas to everyone and whatever holiday you celebrate. Happy or merry, whatever it is. So I'm tired of this politically correct bullshit about just say happy holidays. Fuck that. I'm saying happy and Merry Christmas and whatever you celebrate. Happy and merry. So let's not be political correct in here, because I hate political correctness, and I hope you guys do too. So, all right. Let's go ahead and play. We're playing a DDEX1-3. A couple of other things. I am needing players for Saturday night, guys. I need at least one more player. So if you're looking to play in a game, check out my Patreon page. And it's patreon.com/digitaldungeonmaster, and sign up for the Saturday night game. I'm also looking for more players for Friday night too. You can sign up at the level, I think it's a $10 level, where you can get into the Adventures League games. And as more people join the Adventures League games, I will expand the Adventures League game night from Friday to Thursday and Friday. And even if more join, then I'll extend it to Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So, all right. So let's get going. That's all I've got to say. So we're going to play for a couple of hours tonight. And, yeah. So Merry Christmas. That's right, Deverick. Good to see you, Deverick. Good to see all you guys. Sandman, Tyr, good to see all you guys. Wazgob, what's up, man? Well, I love that name, Wazgob. All right. You got smashed, Wazgob. All right, guys. Let's kind of recap it a little bit, and we'll get going. Does anybody else besides Joe want to do a recap? Joe seems to do all of them. Hey, how about anybody beside Joe or Dragonbait? Because those two guys usually do them all. Anyone?
I haven't got my notes on me at the moment, unfortunately.
Alright. Alright, go ahead then, Dragonbait. Let's get going.
Alright. Last time, we had a lot of different things happen, and we collected a lot of different information. The adventure started out with our characters taking care of a lot of personal business, and Omi's personal business actually went awry and landed him in jail for a couple days, which was quite an adventure in itself. After he got out of jail, the adventurers got together and were summoned by Yovir Glandon, High Priest of Kelimvor, to come out to Valhingen Graveyard to have a discussion with him. Once we arrived there, he told us about rumors of a ghost ship attacking small villages with undead. He also told us about a madman that had been brought to the temple. So we went to this temple and to speak with this madman, who was informally called Yip, because that's the sound he kept making.
Yip, yip, and, yip.
And he kept talking about the eyes of a Dracolich. He kept repeating the eyes, the eyes. And while we were at the temple, we also picked up some holy water and got a muffin, bran muffin blessed while we were there.
Yeah, that tasted really good.
From there, one of our party members had the idea to track down Sergeant Hearn, who directed us to Alaid Barral, who told us that she was worried that Flan might eventually be attacked by all these attacks that have been occurring at villages surrounding Flan. She's the one actually who found the madman, and when she found the madman had blade wounds on him. And then she also told us that Vig's dock was attacked, and that there were like several farmhouses that had been attacked somewhere to the west of Flan, and they were getting closer. The odd thing about the attacks is that there was a lack of survivors and nothing of real value taken from the attacks. Also, there were child-sized tracks at the sites of these attacks. And the attacks have been occurring at, she told us that the attacks have been occurring at regular intervals, and she predicted that there would be another night attack in approximately 2 days. And then, if the pattern held, Flan would be hit 4 days subsequently thereafter. From there, we went to visit Philistram Wonder and Doodle, who was somewhat of a gnome sage. He had a jar of toe bones, which were taken from the site of one of the attacks. These toe bones had holes in them, possibly to be used as necklaces, and he thought that they maybe belong. These were toes, maybe belonged to kobolds, orcs, or goblins. From there, a few of our party members were met by their faction associates who received various faction assignments. Afterwards, we set out to visit a fortune teller named Delacre. We consulted with her, and she told us that she would send a crow with our with the reading we requested whenever it was ready. So heading out, heading out of the west gate, guard Burl stopped us, and he said as long as we're heading out in this direction, he wanted us to look for a merchant caravan that is a couple days late arriving to Flan. Said the merchant's name was Gilfran Millen, and he had a son who was about 10 years old, and he wanted to know why they had not arrived in Flan. And this was to occur, and this was somewhere along the Iron Route, which is a road which stretches from Flan to Zenkeep. The travel time to the village we estimated to be approximately 1 day.
Nice job on the recap. Very nice.
Thank you.
All right, so you guys are on the Iron Route. You left the night before. Razwin uses tent. So as you can hear, you guys can hear a campfire crackling in the background. So what are you guys discussing? Because we kind of ended it. I don't want to say abruptly, but we had a great stopping point as you were leaving Flan. So it's the middle of the night. You guys have pitched tents, especially Olverus. What are you guys doing sitting around this campfire as the rain starts to shower down on you very lightly at this moment in time? Love it.
I'm sitting polishing my spoons, as they say. Looks like we got quite a mystery on our hands here, guys.
Yeah, it's reflecting what it is doing these attacks. Rumors of the undead and alike, but I don't see how that sort of power of undead could be wandering through lands and quite as unnoticed. It doesn't kind of add up.
Shin's just checking out the location of the moon. Does it look like it's where it should be? The constellations, the stars are in their appropriate places where they're supposed to be at.
All right. What about
it's raining. How can you see the moon?
What about what's going on with you, Varus?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Everybody can hear.
Okay, I was just making sure my mic wasn't muted. muted. If it's raining, I'm in my tent. I'm gonna stay dry.
At least you're getting good use out of that that tent, right?
You sleeping?
Yep. No, I'm just in there probably reading a book by the campfire light that reflects off the campfire. Right. But I'm staying dry. I don't want to get wet.
It's raining lightly. It's not like it's pouring down on you or anything like that, so. Markish, what about you?
Normally, Markish is always in for a good joke now and then. I look over to Omi and say, "Those damn spoons are polished enough. Don't you know a good joke around here rather than slapping spoons on yourself?" Every campfire needs a couple of good ones. Let's go. Start us off.
All right. How about a limerick this time? How's that sound?
Oh, I love a limerick. Let's go.
All right. It was a salty old sailor named Bates who tripped over a stack of wooden crates. He fell on his cutlass, which rendered him nutless. Now he's practically useless on dates.
That's classic.
I look over at Shen and say, "Hey, good you one. Sailor boy, you've heard that one before, I'm sure."
Yes, more than once. Good more one. Than once. Yes, yes.
You gotta have some good salty tales from the sea. Come on, Shen. Give us one.
Shen was the one they actually wrote that joke. Well, that nice little joke for, actually.
I know that guy. I don't got nothing. Sorry.
Well, I got a salty one about a dwarf named Dorothy.
About Dorothy, let's hear it.
We all know Dorothy doesn't have a beard anymore because of a singe, right? So. It's more about dwarves than about her, but just how many dwarves would it take to change out a candle? The answer would be 5. It's 1 to hold the bulb and 4 to drink till the room spins.
Ah.
And the last one would be the difference between... Yeah, anyone know the difference between a dwarf and a fairy?
Nope.
Well, telling the fairy the dwarf isn't an insult.
Ooh, I like that one. Sure, you guys are probably already tired of those crits and fumble noises already. All right. Everybody's had a good night's sleep. Everybody deduct a day's worth of rations from your inventory, please. And the sun rises. The rain is still actually falling, though. It's still falling at a very gentle pace. It's not hammering down on you or anything like that. So
I'd like to know if I can hear Vera sleeping at all.
Sure.
Throughout the night.
I'm sure you probably could, yeah.
Maybe during my watch.
Yeah, you can look over at his tent and see that he's snoring inside.
I'm going to try and
I don't
sneak
snore.
I would like to like sneakily poke holes in the top of his tent so that rain gets in on him.
Oh God!
I don't sleep either. I'm in a trance.
Why don't we just de-pitch the tent, move the tent, and leave him where he's lying, and put the tent up somewhere else?
Oh, I like to cut the ropes, just pick it up and move it.
Yeah. So just leave him lying where he is.
Well, if he's in a trance, he might. I don't know. If he's in a trance, you're in a pretty deep meditating state. So I would probably have to say you need to roll a perception check. I think that would
be
fair.
Do it with stealth. Do it with stealth to make sure that to
sure.
try and let him stay asleep.
Sure.
All right. I'll do a stealth check against his perception check.
All right. So
I'm gonna use inspiration on this.
Okay. Before you guys roll, put those into the tower. And Varus, I want you to give me a perception roll in the tower also, please. So I want to see what the heck is going on here. And I love this new extension with the bigger font. Thank you, Lord Gwydion. Lord Gwydion, man. What a stud. great new extension for the font size. Well, as you guys are fumbling around, Varus, actually, you're awoken out of your transic state, and you start to feel the tent rumble all around you. It feels like you're sliding across the ground, Varus.
Hey, man, what gives?
Orcs everywhere. Get out.
Orcs.
I grab my two short swords and head out. Where's the work?
All right, so when you head out, you're all, you know, getting into like a combat type of rage, and all of a sudden you look around and all you see is just Markish pulling your tent. Well, of course, Kel'ash is involved too, so.
Oh, Cal had this stupid idea about messing with you. Just go back to bed. Sorry.
You'll turn for watch.
My turn for the watch?
Yeah, no, so we just...
Sun has already come up. That was at the very end of the last watch.
Oh, we got next week. We need
it's time to get up anyway.
Yeah, if you got some breakfast, you can start making it.
Yeah, the sun has come up. Like I said, the rain is still drizzling down on you. It is a semi-overcast day. Sun's come up. Birds are really not... They're not chirping this morning because of the rain. But you can see occasional birds flying over and whatnot.
So are we where we're supposed to be, or do we still have to travel?
You guys are here. Here's the map of the Moon Sea.
Yeah, I think we've got about another day to wait before the Jew attack.
You guys have traveled a little bit, and like I said, you guys are riding on horseback also. So you've had some horsies lent to you. And you guys are packing all of your goods up and, well, packing all of your equipment up, putting your tent away, I suppose, and getting ready to get back on the road. The horses are grazing and kind of drinking out of small puddles on the ground, too, so. Or whatever buckets that you set up for them, if you had done that. Well, you guys are really quiet tonight.
Are we able to... It's the morning now. Have we gotten a raven from that old lady yet?
You have not. Not yet.
And during our travels, we kind of kept an eye out for, say, cart tracks that looked like they may have gone off the road, or that request from Guard Burl. I guess we're just kind of keeping an eye out. I'd like to keep an eye out for this merchant and his son.
Yeah, there's no wagon tracks in the present location where you're at.
Nothing in the mud, nothing recent.
Nothing recent, because you guys would have probably heard it go by anyway, so.
Do you guys think Delacray scammed us, or do you think she's actually going to send us a message?
I think no matter what she does, it's crazy. That old bat. Even if you got a raven, I don't know if I trust it.
So, did you actually poke holes in my tent?
No, I got talked into trying to move it. Really should have done it, though.
Oh, okay.
I can just see you standing over a tent with your knife out.
Daggers in hand.
And just ready to poke into it. Yep. And then all of a sudden, nothing.
Sees the shadow or something.
Yeah.
Move the opening to right in front of the latrine hole.
Oh, God. All right, so you guys get everything packed up. No holes in your tent, Varus. Everything put away, you get back on your horses, and you're proceeding west along the road.
I'd like to make some good time. Iron route. I don't want to take a slow pace, but I do want to keep a watchful eye. I'd like to get it to this spot as soon as possible, so we can do some investigating before the night's activities.
Sure.
Yeah, trying to suss out the area, kind of work out what best location is to maybe be defensive stance and stuff like that.
You guys are on the Iron Route. As you know, this is the main road that goes along the north side of the Moon Sea. You know, it runs from, as you can see on the map, it runs from Zental Keep to the west, all the way to Flan, and then even beyond, even further west and further east. Now, you guys are traveling pretty swiftly, pretty safely. You know, nothing's going on except for the rain. Horses aren't having any kind of issues or anything like that. And everything's going as pretty much as expected. And although there has been some unpredictable trouble along this coast, now, as the sun starts to come a little bit higher overhead, you know, these storm clouds are still letting a light rain on you. And you can see it's not a complete overcast day. And you're well on your way west. And I would say probably around noon or so, off in the distance as you start to, you know, come over a small little rolling hill, you can see that there's a wagon pulled off to one of the sides of the road. And it looks like it's kind of tilted, probably with like a broken axle. And then as you get closer, you can see it does have a broken axle. And you can see two people there. You can see a young boy that's sort of off to the side, tending to a campfire as you're riding up. And then there's another man that looks totally like a merchant. And, you know, he's got long clothing and stuff. And he's digging into the front of the wagon on one of those packs. And as you guys start to ride up, you know, he hears the horses coming up behind him. He turns around. The boy sees you. He kind of stands up, starts to walk over by the rear of the wagon, and you can see him kind of peering around. And it's, you know, the older gentleman, he kind of stops out in the middle of the road, and he puts his hand up, and he says, "Hail, my friends, hail!" And he's kind of like waving, like he's trying to get your attention, which obviously you had already seen him anyway. So he's waving his hands. He says, "Hail, my friends, hail! Hail!"
Greetings. What seems to be the problem?
As you can see, I've got a broken axle on my wagon, and I'm trying to get to Flan. Do you guys think you could lend me some muscle, maybe? My name is Gilfrin Millen, and I am a lumber merchant from the Quivering Forest. If you need anything, like tools or anything, I have those as well, so I'm a merchant at your service.
Please, Major Gilfrin. Yes, I may have a need your services and some of your wares. I'm sure we could give you a hand in some respect. Unfortunately, we won't be going back to Flan for a day or so, but I'm sure we could try and help you fix your wagon so you could make your way.
Oh, that's no problem. I've missed a couple of meetings already with some possible clients in Flan. I was supposed to arrive last night, but with my broken axle and all, I have my son with me, and we just don't have enough umph, I guess you could say, between the two of us to get this, you know, this wagon up to where I can fix the wheel and whatnot, and the axle. But if you guys could give us a little bit of a hand, I'm sure maybe we could work out a deal. Maybe I could give you a couple of tools, or maybe I could even give you a little credit, or maybe even give you a couple coins.
I'm fair sure enough. That could be done.
You know a guard Burl back in Flan.
Yes, she's usually tending one of the gates that I usually check in when anytime a wagon or caravan comes into Flan, we usually have to check in. Yeah, I remember the name, absolutely. Why?
She was worried about you. She, as we were heading out, she asked us to keep an eye out for you and your son.
Oh, wow. Wow, it's nice to see Flan actually expecting their merchants and actually worrying about the expected merchants that are supposed to be traveling through. Wow. I feel
yeah,
like
she
a,
said, so long
I feel like I've 10 been... gold coins right now to hear that.
10, that might be what I had in mind as well.
He seems like a pretty happy guy, you know. He is literally drenched from head to toe. You know, you can just see the water just dripping and just kind of like running off of his robe. He's been trying to get this, and you can tell that there's a lot of struggle marks on that back axle where the wagon's kind of leaning down. He's been trying to, you know, there's all kinds of pieces of lumber and a couple of jacks and whatnot. He just can't get this damn thing up off of the ground. He does look over and he says, it is almost lunchtime. Would you like to join us for a little bit of food before, if you guys want to help? You know, hey, you're more than welcome to join us.
My son, mentioned?
He's good with my son's good with a bow, and you're more than welcome to join us. He has a rabbit and a duck cooking over the spit. There was a group of ducks that were swimming by this morning, and my son took a shot and got one. And then there was a duck. He also got a duck too. Wow, he's such a good shot. He didn't shoot all the baby ducks, so he just let them go.
So we're sure they'll survive.
We're not having any kind of venison duck or anything. Just but yeah, you can see over, yeah, you can actually see over the he has like a sort of like a rotisserie rack over the fire, and these things are just his son's over there kind of turning them. You know, you could see that there's two pieces of meat up there.
While we're waiting for this to finish off cooking, why don't we have a little entertainment? I'm sure Omi here would be more than willing to play a little song with his spoons.
Absolutely.
And I'd be happy to join him by playing a little merry tune on my flute to accompany his spoons.
Oh, they don't need artisans, you fools. They need muscle to lift this and change the axle.
Like we said, we'd help him with the muscle after we've had some light lunch.
Gilfrin says, "Dear, a good bod, sir, will your song make my wagon levitate?" And he kind of chuckles.
Will you? Only it could. The things I can make levitate of the women, that would be amazing. Unfortunately, I am not of that bardic powers to be able to achieve such feats.
Don't worry, I can provide motivation.
Too good.
I don't think I have much muscles though. As I look at my bicep, and Omi is shaggy, skinny.
So as you guys go over to the little camp area that he has, you know, he introduces you to his son, and his son's name is Gilmont. And you know, he says, as you guys start to sit down and whatnot, and actually he breaks out a really nice cask of elvish wine. And he starts, you know, getting everyone a nice big metal cup, you know, and starts filling it up. And he says, "Yeah, ever since my wife died, she died of a fever 3 years ago, my son travels in my company now, learning the family business. And one day..."
"Where do you hail from?"
"All of this is going to be his." "Well, we are from the Quivering Forest, and we do have several wagons. That's not only manned by me, but my other business associates as well. And we travel around the area and sell the lumber. You know, we have permission from the elves of the Quivering Forest, and that's what we do. Sell tools and lumber."
"So, how long have you been traveling the Iron Road from the east?"
"Well, we left actually from Hillsfar, and we are, you know, we got some, another, it takes us quite a few months to do a circuit. I call it the circuit. And about every 3 months or so, we end up back in Flam. 3 to 4 months, depends on where we go. But we did start, this time we started in Hillsfar, which is to the south. It's on the opposite end of the Moon Sea, where you guys are at now, basically. And I'll move
that
little pointer on here."
"Quite a distance. That's
He says, it is. He says, that's why it takes quite a few months. And you can see on his wagon, there's all kinds of axes and saws and, you know, long blades and pulleys, all kinds of ropes, you know, 10-foot poles, everything. All kinds of metal goods. Anything that has to do with working lumber, you know, he's selling it. And also, excellent, he's got some other stuff as well, some basic equipment he has as well. But he seems really friendly."
"What can I procure some tools and lumber for a shipment to the temple in the center of Flan when you do arrive. We're looking to reconstruct the old Temple of Bane there into a multi-faith temple. And all provisions would be greatly appreciated, sir. I'm willing to purchase some off yourself, if, by all means. Just curious on how much it would cost.
Well, I tell you what. Since you're doing me a favor, I will give you the tools that you need. And I'll give you any kind of extra lumber that I have left over that isn't sold in Flan. So whatever I have left over, I will, because Flan is my last stop, and I'll let you have whatever. It'd just make it easier on my horses on the way back. So,
Marrakesha, should we try and lift this wagon up and see if we can get this fixed before lunch?
Well, we don't have to rush it. I mean, we can go ahead. We can eat the, you know, we can eat first. I mean, it's not a problem.
You work then eat. That's how this works.
Ah, well, but hey, I'm not build going to.
I could use a bit of time off this bloody horse anyway.
that sounds good to me. My son will finish cooking. Just let us know, son, whenever it's done. He goes, okay, Dad. So as you guys are going over to work on the wagon, you know, he tells you he has a little. You know, he just has a small company, just a handful of wagons, and you know, like you said, he just sells anything that has to do with lumber all along the Moon Sea. And you know, sometimes he deals in large quantities and stuff, and you know, that's when his other associates, they take care of the larger, you know, larger orders and stuff. Now he also says, yeah, we should hurry a little bit, because there's been a lot of raided villages and homes along the Moon Sea. He says, as a matter of fact, there was a village that I stopped at that I usually stay and bathe and have a nice hot meal, but it was in ruins and it was smoldering, and there was no one there. I was actually taken back by it. So
How long ago was that when you were there?
That was a couple of days ago, just 2 days ago. And there was no one there, and then other, you know, I've ran into a couple of other merchants that I usually see every couple months, and we had stopped and talked and actually discussed that I've actually found out that there's been more than just this attack on this small town. Actually, it's been happening all across the Moon Sea coast. I've never seen anything like this in the 20 years that I've been running this route.
Well, merchants always hear the rumors. What do you hear?
I'm just worried for my boy. I just don't want him to get hurt if there, you know, anything. But something that my son told me a couple of days ago. We actually took a ferry because there's been quite a few rains. And a couple of the roads have been flooded out, so we had to take a ferry. And as we took this ferry, the driver of the boat, or the boatman, he mentioned a Dracolish. He was a strange man. And he had this long stare. He would just look at you, and he just mentioned to my son, and this
did
is what
he
my,
a lot?
My son told me. Did he what, sir?
Did he yip a lot?
Yip? What do you mean, yip?
Make a sound going yip, yip, yip.
Oh, no, 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 no. No, he just told my son about a Dracolich, and he said that this thing would be haunting the area. I have no clue. But, you know, this bay, there's all kinds of these crazy stories that are coming off of the boatmen, you know, that I mean, these crazy stories are always too common, but it does make me wonder, because these crazy stories never deal with any kind of dragons or whatnot. He was a strange man, though. But no, he did not say yip, but he was spouting such a tale to my son.
You say anything about the eyes?
About an eyes? No, he
dragon
he was,
eyes
was telling my son that his island village sheltered some kind of soul that I don't know. It just sounded too far, but it just sounded strange. It wasn't your typical, you know, sailor moon sea tale. But this man had seen something, you know, with all kinds of these visions and whatnot. And then after that, after we got off the ferry, we passed several other points, and there were no other ferries that we could have taken, so we had to really take the long route around. I don't know. Maybe the man seen something. I don't know, but you know. My son told me, and I just don't know. These tales of the moon sea sometimes are just a little far fetched, if you ask me. I have never seen nothing in 20 years.
Well, everybody knows how sailors talk. Yeah. Why don't you say we get to work?
All right.
I give Shed kind of a look while I do it.
All right. So let's do a group strength check to see if we can get this thing up. You know, he has another axle. He's got another wheel. The wheel's fine.
Does it look as though it's like, can I do an inspection and kind of see what maybe the axle broke on? Was it something get hit, or does it look malicious, or does it look as though just a haphazard break?
Give me an investigation check. And do you have a?
Oh, wrong one. Sorry.
Oh, okay. Do you have the same bonus or what?
Yeah.
That's a good roll. So, yeah, you can tell that this is just wear and tear. It just snapped. Doesn't look like it. You don't see any kind of saw marks or anything like that. Just wear and tear. You know, the tire's fine. He's got the axle. He's got several axles, actually, as any, you know, Wagoneer would have. And all it needs is to be picked up to a certain height so the axle can run through, and you know, you're gonna have to reattach both wheels. But other than
that, we do an athletics check.
Yeah, you guys can go ahead.
Does the axle appear to be broken in such a manner that I can repair it with a spell of mending?
Sure. I think mending would work for that, right? It's any wooden objects, aren't?
Pretty minor things, I think.
Anything less than 1 foot, no larger than 1 foot in any dimension.
Well, yeah, it's actually about. I would say it's probably about a 5 foot long axle. What was the wagon? Probably 5-6 foot wide, maybe 8 foot wide.
Did it snap in a certain spot, or?
Yeah, it just snapped in a certain spot. I mean, if you think about it, you could just mend that one spot together. Sure.
Yeah. So rather than replace the axle, we could pick it up and he could cast his.
That would be pretty cool.
If we lifted it level, so made sure the axle was straight, and then cast it.
Yeah. Right. Sure.
So I'll be lifting.
I'll help you lift as well.
Yeah. As you guys are discussing this, you know, Gilfron is just amazed. He's like, magic and. Fix my axle? That is astonishing. All right, so it looks like who all is lifting the wagon? All five of you, or what?
Marrakesh.
I think it's Kel and Marrakesh.
Omi, don't be standing on this thing playing your spoons. Get off if you are there.
You said athletics, right?
Yep, athletics or strength.
Don't you think I'm more useful to you playing some motivational music?
Actually, athletics, there should be another plus two on that day for my role.
Okay.
I'm standing by to do the mending cantrip.
Varus.
I
try to lift and slip in the mud on my butt.
Oh, you do. You get just head to toe. I mean, you just get up and all you can see is eyes and teeth, man. You just fell face first right into a pool of mud.
I drag my scrawny 100-pound frame up there and try to help out as best I can.
Yeah, you do. But with all of you, you know, you're able to hold it up, you know, and then he puts like a horse under it, like a horsey, and not an actual one of his live horses, but a wooden horse, and he props it up, and you guys are able to set it down. So you're able to do your mending spell, right? Cantrip. You do your spell. You do it a couple times. Yes. You mend the axle. Everything appears to be good. You get it all lined up just perfectly. And he's just astonished. He goes, well, that was a lot of work. I've worked up an appetite. Are you guys ready to eat now? He says, "Is it okay if we take it off this horse? Will the mending be okay? Are you really sure about this? Will it really hold?" And he just keeps asking, "Is this magic going to be good enough? Wow, this is amazing."
Should hold you just fine.
Okay, so you guys take it, lift the wagon back off of the horse, let it down, and you guys gather around the campfire, and his son starts giving you guys plates of rabbit and duck and a few dirty potatoes that were kind of sitting in the ashes cooking. So you guys are having a pretty good lunch, yeah. But this time, there's a little bit of thunder that's starting to happen way off into the distance, and it seems the rain is kicking up just a little bit more now.
And it's this night that the attack's going to happen, isn't it?
Or is it tomorrow now?
Night? Yeah,
it's
we need
this
to
night.
Going
it's tonight before. Where the attack's going to happen, or is it tomorrow night?
I believe it
is
was tonight.
Day two? Yeah, I believe it's
yeah.
Two
days, in the middle of the night, yeah. So you have, like, what, a day and a half still?
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Yeah. All right. So you guys are mowing down, and, you know, he just... He asks you guys, where do all of you guys come from?
We've just come from Flan to kind of investigate what's been happening on these attacks that have been coming down the edge of the Moon Sea, trying to work out what the situation is.
Do you live there in Flan?
We are currently residing in Flan, yes. I originally hail from Hillsfar, but we're currently residing in Flan and helping Flan out and helping it to rebuild itself.
Mm. Let's take a quick 5-minute break. All right, guys? This medicine that I'm taking is like just killing me. All right, see you guys in 5. All right, everybody. We will be back in 5 minutes. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for watching. We will be right back.
All the time.
So I'd like to know, as much as Gilfrun has heard of anything going on the north side of the Moon Sea, if he's heard anything more than a passing ferryman talking about a Dracolich or a burned village or an empty village.
Yeah, well, when you say that, his son's eyes light up, you know. They light up like headlights on a car. And he said, he kind of leans over to his dad and he says, "Dad, did you tell him? He says, "Oh, I mentioned some of it, yes, son."
And I look at the girlfriend, I said, or Gilmont, and I said, "Tell us what, son? Keep share what you know."
We haven't seen really anyone over the last week. It's been a really spooky trip. I mean, I've only been traveling with my dad for maybe a couple of years ever since my ma died. But we haven't seen anybody on this trip. Wow, this lightning's getting pretty close too. We may have to climb into the wagon, Pop. But we haven't seen it. But we saw a village a couple days back. It was destroyed, but the only people that we saw was the island fairy. It was a day back. We were trying to get around this really bad part of the Iron Road, and when we were going, I love boats, and I would love to be able to own a boat one day and drive it on the Moon Sea. That would be so great. Maybe one day, huh, Dad?
Focus, boy.
But anyways, sorry about that. I was hanging out with the boatman up front, the driver of the boat, and he kept saying that he was worried about the storm coming in the next day or so, which would have been today. Wow, he was so good. He must be some kind of seer or something that can see into the future. But all he kept saying is he had this weird look on his face and talking about this storm coming, and then he started telling me about these crazy stories about this Dracolich that's going to be haunting the area. And he said he was going to, you know, happen all along the Moon Sea and in all the bays and whatnot. And then my dad came and I said, "Dad, did you hear this story about the undead dragon?" And my dad told me to go to the back of the boat. But it was just weird. But he kind of talks a little bit quieter. And he says, Dad, I didn't tell you this part, but when we were getting off the ferry, this merchant, it's like the thunder went away. Wow, we're like really lucky, aren't we? Oh, I just had to press the button again. There we go, it's back. So, as we were leaving the ferry, ooh, that was close. The boat taker, as he was helping the wagon come off, he made some kind of like strange digging like gesture with his I think it was his left hand, and he was like doing this digging gesture sort of like pointing towards the ground, and I remember it was with his like his pinky and his forefinger. So all of you arcanic people, all of you, anybody that specializes in magic, give me an intelligence check, and if you have arcana, you can do that. This would be for the casters, and drop it into the tower, please, if you guys want. All right, so, well, everybody has arcana, huh? Nice.
I have it as part of Jack of All Trades, so I don't know how that works.
Varys and Omi, both of you, you guys remember, especially with, you know, being with the temple and whatnot, and all kinds of meditating and healing and whatnot. As he says that, you guys remember, you would recognize this gesture as used in spells as part of like a somatic component, that this would mean that as you're pointing down towards the ground with your fingers, it's like a protection against creatures from other planes. you know, whether it be undead or whatnot. So that's usually casting, you know, the, like the, like I said, it's like the somatic type of component that would be for using to cast any kind of protect against creatures.
That motion sounds like kind of protection spell to me.
I agree.
Hey, it was pretty distinctive, as you know, the kid told you.
But protection from what?
Creatures from the other planes.
From creatures from other planes, guys.
Because you would use that somatic component, but the verbal part could be different, whether it be undead or whatever. So he didn't hear anything. He just saw the motion and the gestures going down.
So maybe there is something to these ghost stories.
Yeah, somebody was protecting themselves. The ferryman was, anyway.
Or at least they thought so.
Yeah, the father looks over, you know. Girlfriend says, I thought you told me everything, son. You should have told me all of that. This are troubling times, son. If you know something, you need to speak up. That could mean the difference between life and death, son.
Listen to your father,
okay,
boy.
Okay, Dad. Boy, this roast duck sure is good, isn't it? My mom told...
Yes, excellent
cook,
son.
My mommy told me how to cook. She taught me. My mommy.
There's no time to act like that, boy. These are tough times. Act the man. Your father will need the help.
All right. You guys want to ask him anything else? Gilfron does want to get moved on. He wants to, you know, now that the wagon is fixed, you guys have been eating and drinking. He starts to put things away. And in fact, he's not even really cleaning anything up. He just tells his son to, you know, finish loading up the wagon. They're going to be on their way with a hurried pace towards Flan. And he thanks all of you. And Gilfron says, what do I owe thee? What do I owe all of you? Somebody's doing feedback too.
I'm happy for just some tools and supplies to help out rebuild the temple, but I don't know about my fellows here.
When you get to town, make sure and give Guard Burl the name of Markesh.
I will.
I'd like a 10-foot pole.
You can have a 10-foot pole. You're more than welcome.
Shin doesn't need anything.
I'll look through his carpenter's tools and see if he has anything that's useful that I can add to my bag.
Sure, he's got, you know, basic wood tools and whatnot. Whatever you need, you can go ahead and take.
Get to Flan today. It's not safe. These roads are not safe.
He kind of looks up. Today. He kind of licks his thumb, sticks his thumb up into the air, feels the wind. He says, "I think we can make it by nightfall." And then he tells you, Kalash. He says he'll deliver whatever extra lumber and wood, nails, anything like that. He'll deliver it to the temple. And
that'd be great. Thank you very much. I hope you have a safe journey back to Flan.
Well, as do I. And he starts to journey off, and then you can see that wheel is wobbling. Whoop, whoop, whoop. No, I'm just kidding. Yep. So he's off.
We didn't say it was a good mending, mending spell,
right?
But it, but to get into Flan,
we just got some duck and rabbit for that mending spell. I mean, come on.
Yeah, so I'd start gathering up my horse and encouraging everyone to do the same. We'd need to make it to this destination.
Yeah, we need to make
plenty of time
there.
To spare, so we need to make haste.
If we make good time now, we might be able to get there before nightfall. And then we've got a whole day to prep and see what's happening before the reported a tax due.
The weather, is it still just, is it heavy raining now, or is it light rain with a lot of thunder and lightning?
It's raining harder than what it was, but it's not quite a downpour. Not quite yet.
In which direction did the storm come from?
It just came from whatever direction you want it to come from.
Okay, so it's not coming from the direction we're going then.
Only if you say it is.
No, I wanted to determine whether it's something to do with what we're going up against or anything.
Could be. It could be, because remember, the boatman did mention a storm, and it is now a day later from when it was mentioned, and it is storming. And like I said, the lightning wasn't apparent at first, but after time, you know, as the sun come up, you know, it is more overcast now. You can't even really barely see the sun anymore. And now it's starting, you know, you can see lightning off into the distance in all directions, and you can hear the thunder. And it is raining harder, but it's not a torrential downpour or anything.
Okay.
All right.
So make all right, move.
Guys, let's hit the road. I'll play some traveling music for us.
Oh God, please don't.
Oh God, here we go.
Shen, Shen can sing. I'll play. I'll play the spoons while Shen sings.
A merry sailor song.
Yep, you're a sailor. You should be able to hit the high seas.
Boat up, boat.
Well, these maps fucking suck, man.
That was good. I like that.
All right, so we actually know where our destination is.
Yeah, this ferry. The ferry landing.
Yeah, it's okay. Marked on the road. Yeah, sure. Yeah, you travel.
Any raven? So.
Not yet. I'll let you know if the raven shows up. That's for sure. I promise. I will let you know.
Alright, so I think we need to head towards this spot and get there as soon as we're able to.
Alright, so it's raining. You guys are traveling along this now. You know, you're having to travel a little bit slower. Well, because of, you know, all of the puddles of mud and whatnot, the horsies and all that other good stuff. You know, you don't want them slipping and sliding around, so. So up ahead, you guys are starting to hear a very high pitch, sort of like a rustling off, you know, up into the bushes. I mean, it's actually what catches your attention is the yipping sound. It's like a yip 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 yip, and then you start to see
that crazy bastard follow us.
Yeah. Well, the roadside brushes are starting to, you know, move and whatnot. And then all of a sudden, a wolf pup runs out into the middle of the road in front of you. And then it's followed by another wolf pup and another one. And they're all tackling each other and having a good time in the mud and in the water. And then, as you guys are approaching, and I'm going to give you guys the map. Here it is here. As you guys are getting a little bit closer, I'm gonna put, we'll say the wolves will be right here where this they're playing right around in this area here. Now I'll put all you guys here on the map, and these do represent you being on horseback as well. So
did you guys hear that?
Oh yeah, you guys can see these.
See,
I mean, they're about 20-25 feet up. You know, 25 feet up on you. And it was a very loud yip, and you could even hear this over the, you know, even over the thunder, over the, you know, you guys are probably about, so you guys are probably about right here, so. Ugh, come on. Probably about right here, so. I know where this 15-foot line is. You guys see the wolves, and then all of a sudden, a louder growl starts to resonate from the rear behind you. I mean, a much, much louder growling. And all of a sudden, you see a wolf start to emerge out of the bush. And this wolf looks like this, and I'm going to give you an image. Of course, there's no image for this.
That's a big wolf.
It is. Let me find an image for you. There may not be. So, basically, what this wolf looks like, it is rather large. It is about, probably from head to tail, probably about 7-8 feet. This thing has cartilage sticking out of its neck, out of its back. It has glowing red eyes, and it's growling at you, and it looks like it's going to pounce and attack. So everybody go ahead and roll initiative, because to the north of you, on both on the left and the right on the road, the bushes are really trembling hard, and you can start to hear more of these growls as well.
Looks like a bit of an ambush, boys.
Yeah, and the little, you know, these little pups that were yipping, all of a sudden they start to yelp, yeep, 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 and they run off behind the bushes. All right, so you guys are rolling. All right, the other wolves appear. Markish, you're up first.
Yeah, I need to get off the horse for sure. Will that take some movement of mine?
That would take an action. We don't do mounted stuff very often, but I believe in the player's handbook it is an action to get off. Let me double check that. I wanted to read up on mounted combat again in 5e because I don't use it that much. But I've been so under the weather, I just passed my mind. So you can go ahead and you can get off for an action. And yep. If it's not an action, I'll reward you with something next round.
No, you're good. I will definitely get off with an action and slap the backside of my horse to run to the south, or away from where we're at.
Apparently, during your movement, you can mount a creature that is within 5 foot of you or dismount. Doing so costs the amount of movement equal to half your speed.
So that it doesn't take the action, it just takes movement?
About half your speed of movement to mount.
So it's like coming up from being prone, I suppose.
That's good. I like that. And I like that more than being in action. So
you must spend 15 feet of movement to mount a horse. Therefore, you can't mount if you don't have 15 foot of movement left.
All right, so
speed is
it's like standing up. That's good. I like that. That's good. So, all right, you get off your horse. You have half your movement left. What say you,
Markish? Yeah, so as a bonus action, I'd like to slap the horse on the butt to have him run to the south away from the battle.
Sure.
Away from the dire wolves. So I don't really want to pay for that.
Okay.
And then. Yeah. Did you want to lock these, or no?
Unfortunately, your horse gets lost.
Well, have to chase him down.
Then I will move there with the rest of my movement and take a defensive position.
Okay, sure. The defense
shields
action.
Out. Yeah. Yep, shields out, defense action.
Shields up, number one.
And right. that will be my turn.
Okay, very good. Let's move it down to Shen. So Shen, you're ready to go.
Shen will dismount as well, and send his horse off, and then cast, as I see Markish move towards the wolf closest to us, I will cast Sacred Flame on that wolf.
Emperor Grenar, thank you so much for hosting. I appreciate it. All right. The wolf was actually successful with its dexterity saving throw. Thank you so much for the follow as well.
It's the rain. I blame the rain.
Blame it on the rain.
You beat me to blame. Was that Millie Vanilli?
Yes, I can't remember. Was.
Yeah, the old lip syncers. I love it. All right, so I've got Mounted Combat up there. If anybody's gonna use it or anything, there's really not much to Mounted Combat in 5e. So
we don't think these were really war horses either. So
no, definitely not. Okay, so it looks like Shen, you've cast. Nothing else is gonna happen. Let's pass it on to the wolves, shall we? Blame it on the rain. Yeah. I might play that song later tonight. That's a good one. Okay, so the first one, the mother wolf, the matriarch. This thing is huge. This thing is going to run up. Let's see. 10, 15, 20, 25. Got plenty of room. It's going to turn towards Omi, and it is going to bite you as it snaps at you. And it misses with a 12. Wow, that font is so awesome, isn't it? Thank you, Lord Gwydolin, for doing this, man. Holy shit, this is an awesome font. All right, so the next wolf moves up and is going to attack Varus. Let's attack. I pick on Varus way too much. But Varus, you are in the worst position, so I swear.
You put me there.
Well, you could have moved. I just put him up there. You could have moved him around. I don't know. You don't care that.
We went in. You moved us there, and then we went into combat.
I usually say put him wherever you want in that area, but I just didn't. I'm not 100%, so I'm not going to attack you anyway, so we're going to attack Marcus.
Oh, it don't matter.
Okay, we'll attack you then.
As you attack him, I'll just... Oh, you attack me anyway.
I did. Okay, so an 18 versus Marcus is a miss, and the last... the last dire wolf moves up and also attacks you as well. I love it. And it misses you. You've got 9 lives. So let's go to Kalash now. You're up now, Kalash.
Well, I'll start off by spending half my movement to climb off my horse, at which point I'm going to hex my target, I think. So I drop that one on myself, and I'm gonna hex Dex on the wolf too, so he's now hexed. Right. And I am going to then step forward one space.
Hex is such a nice spell.
It is awesome.
Amek stays.
And
thank you very much
with my warhammer.
Thank you, Amek. Appreciate it.
And miss.
All right, you do miss. Yeah, you do miss pretty bad. Anything else for you? All right, Varus?
Just so you know, that 18 would have hit me.
No, I would have used protection.
Okay, now the question is...
You've got reactions you can use.
I have green flame.
Mm-hmm.
Are these wolves
how it works
in a position where I can use it?
Yes, they are adjacent to one another. From the corners, yes. Cussing
right,
demon.
I am going to use green flame as I hit wolf one.
Okay.
Which, you're still on your horse, right?
Yeah, he can attack from his horse. When you're controlling your mounts, it talks about mounting and dismounting. Your horse really needs to be trained. I mean, you're kind of in a standstill position, so...
Okay, I'll get off the mount.
Okay.
Smack it in the butt, so run south.
Yeah, it says controlling a mount. While you're mounted, you have two options. You can either control the mount or allow it to act independently. Intelligent creatures such as dragons act independently. You can control a mount only if it has been trained to accept the rider, which yours has. Domesticated horses, donkeys, and similar creatures are assumed to have such training. The initiative of a controlled mount changes to match yours when you mount it. It moves as you direct it, and it has only 3 action options: dash, engage, and dodge. A controlled mount can move and act even on the turn that you mount it. So the mount, if it's going to get attacked, you know, it'll have dodge and stuff. Let's see. An independent mount retains its place in the initiative order. Bearing a rider puts no restrictions on the actions the mount can take, and it moves and acts as it wishes. It may flee, rush to attack, and devour a badly injured foe, depending on what type of creature it is. In either case, if the mount provokes an opportunity attack while you're on it, the attacker can target you or the mount.
Oh.
So, mounting and dismounting, we'll kind of talk about that too, which I'm in no rush. So, once during your move, you can mount a creature that is within 5 feet of you, or dismount it. Doing so costs the amount of movement equal to half your speed. For example, if your speed is 30, you must spend 15 feet of movement to mount the horse. Basically, it's the same thing as standing when you're prone. Therefore, you can't mount if you don't have 15 feet of movement left, or if your speed is zero from, like, being snared, whatever. If an effect moves your mount against its will while you're on it, you must succeed on a DC 10 dexterity saving throw or fall off of the mount, landing prone in a space within 5 feet of the mount. If you're knocked prone while mounted, you must take the same saving throw. If your mount is knocked prone, you can use your reaction to dismount it as it falls and land on your feet. Otherwise, you are fucked. You're dismounted and your head explodes off of your shoulders and your body, with headless, falls into the prone position 5 feet from it.
That's how the pretty cool rules. Horseman was made.
That's it. I like it. So it's very vague. It doesn't talk about actions or anything like that. Only for the horse. So.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not very... When I read it the first time, I was like, this is horrible. but moving, take it off, or if you are going to stay on your mount, it will get an action as well, which would be the only for it though, whether it be dodge or whatnot. So, all right. So that's the horsey rules.
All right. Let's get off the horsey.
All right, Jairus.
So we don't have to deal with it.
All right.
Smack him on the butt, let him send him with south.
All right.
And then I'm going to attack wolf number one. When I hit, use green flame to hit wolf number two.
Okay. Yeah, they're adjacent to one another, so let's see. Green flame is just a regular attack, right? Which would be a hit.
Hit number one.
All right, so roll your damage, and then your green flame blade, I believe, will just actually whip out and hit the other one that's adjacent, right? And do a certain amount of damage.
I think I just got to put the effect on him, the damage on the number two.
Yeah, as on a hit, it attacks normal effects and... Like I was saying, the green fire leaps to the target that is adjacent. So the second creature takes fire damage equal to your spellcasting ability modifier. And then as you get higher level, once you hit level 5, your melee attack will do 1d8 and then still do the splash. So, all right. So let's go ahead and do damage to wolf number 1, which was looks like
4.
I think he did.
4. And then 2 damage to wolf number 2 from the green flame blade that kind of lashes out. Very nice. All right, so it looks like Varus is done. We are moving on to Omi. You are up, sir. Hey, Merry Christmas to you too, Ron.
I yell over to Kel. Kill it, Kel. As I give him bardic inspiration.
And Merry Christmas to everybody. There's 10 gold for everybody.
And then I draw my short sword and try to strike this wolf north-west of me here.
Okay. And don't forget, tomorrow is the Christmas giveaway extravaganza I do every year. Horrible miss, Omi. What say you? What's up?
I slipped in the wet dirt.
That's what it sounded like.
And I got off my horse, by the way.
Alright.
Yeah, I forgot to say that, but yeah.
No problem. You could stay on it if you wanted to. It don't matter to me. So if you wanted to stay on, you could. But well, okay,
maybe providing a little bit of cover, so I'll stay on it. Sure.
Okay. Sure. All right. So what do you want? You seeing that you're staying on, you have the option to do a couple of different things. I guess you want your... Let's see, it has three attack, three action options. You want it to dash, disengage, or dodge.
I'll have it disengage.
Okay, so you can tactically retreat back. I like that. All right, so it can dash, and there you go. You got that much movement left, so we'll do that. Very good. Because it doesn't say use the horse's movement or anything like that, so we'll just assume it's your action. You have that much action, so. All right, Markish, it looks like round two. You're up.
Yeah, so
top
standing
of
with,
the order.
Standing with my shield up, I'm going to take a swing with my battle axe towards one of the two in front of me.
Sure. What's up, Dame? Good to see you. Merry Christmas.
Whoa.
Oh, my gosh. What just happened? Did I just see that?
I think my battle axe went flying right over the head.
It's a willful axe.
Yeah, that was pretty bad. We'll say that you still have your axe. You just fumble the rest of your turn away.
Yep.
All right, so Shen, you're up. Oops, sorry, that was a double tap, just like Zombieland. That was totally delayed. That was like crazy. Oh, my wallet's hurting too, Dame. Believe me, Christmas, doctor bills. Oh my God, it's been horrendous this year. All right, go for it, Shen. You still on the horse, right?
Nope. I'm not on a horse.
Okay.
No, let him go last time.
Okay. So that's right. You're the only person that's still on the horse is Omi. Nice. Congrats, Dame. That's awesome.
And as I've seen, my
companions
have difficulty with hitting these creatures, I will cast Bless.
Ooh, nice.
Like it.
Clutch.
Nice, nice.
See, I believe I get to do that to three companions.
Don't forget, everybody, tomorrow is my Christmas Eve Christmas giveaway extravaganza, the fourth one, 10 p.m. Eastern. Be there, be square. Lots of prizes to give away. D&D books, Fantasy Grounds stuff, all kinds of stuff, guys. Tomorrow night, 10 p.m. Got to be there.
And that's the end of my turn.
All right. All right, so let's see. Direwolf's going to move up right behind you, Varys. It's looking at you like a nice little morsel to bite into. And it chomps away. And it misses. Next, Markish, you're getting attacked. The direwolf snaps at you. Oh, no. Oh, boy, that just happened. I'm so sorry. All right, so, oh my goodness, let's go ahead and give you some crit damage, Markish. Thank goodness you're a half orc. So you take a total of 16 piercing damage. Holy
cow! That could have been worse.
It could have, yeah. Thank goodness I rolled the one and the two. So now I'm gonna make you do a strength saving throw. Wow, that is really good. Awesome.
Can I have you roll for me tonight?
Do what now?
Maybe you can just roll for me tonight.
Yeah, right. No doubt. So you are not... You know, this thing hits you with such force, and you feel like you're going down, and then all of a sudden, you know, you just persevere through it, and you're ready to attack it, so you don't get knocked prone. But you do get hit really heavily. So this dire wolf here, the last one, is going to attack Kalash.
As he does, I use protection.
Okay.
He'll have disadvantage on the attack.
That sounds like a winner to me. I was going to ask if you're going to do that. So let's do the bite attack on Kalash with disadvantage. And you can see Fantasy Ground. Wow, Fantasy Grounds are rolled twice. Thank goodness you did that, because it's 11 versus AC, which is a miss. The other roll would have hit. So good job. Reaction down. Kalash, you just were saved by your... companion beside you, what do you do?
Yeah.
As the wolves are frothing, trying to snap at you guys. Take
you
out.
I'm trying to hit him back with my warhammer.
And you swing, and he kind of does a tumble out of the way.
With that, I'm going to also add the D6 for my bardic inspiration and see if that actually does a difference. So, 19 total.
A 19, I do believe. Wow, that is a horrible miss. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, not funny though.
It's like a crit fumble. No, you hit it. Go ahead. As the wolf starts to tumble, you strike it in as you just kind of follow through with it.
I'm going to use a spell slot and use a divine smite on myself to hit this wolf.
I like it. Oh, nice. Divine. Oh, my God. 29. Wow. With Hex and Divine Smite. Good job. Costs a lot of spell slots, so you got to admit that, Kalash.
It's not so I can use a lot, but it's when I do need it, it's that single heavy hit now and again can be really helpful.
Yeah, that's a heavy hit. 29 damage. This thing is hurt pretty badly. Well, you guys are rolling all kinds of crits, man. The channel's getting all kinds of gold tonight for the crits. Good job, guys. All right, so, Varys, you're up. What say you? Deverick, yes, I am.
Okay, I will.
We're doing our dinner early tomorrow.
Same thing I did last time, the green flame and the hit on Dire Wolf number one.
All right.
And two.
Yeah, definitely, because
still
we're doing our
one, so.
Dinner early, because I'm doing my two giveaway streams tomorrow. Very nice hit, Varys. That bless really helps a lot.
Oh, that's what that was, bless. Let's see, what did it do, roll damage?
Tighten up. Welcome to the game. All right, 6 damage to the first dire wolf. It yelps and staggers back a little bit and seems like it's going to attack you again. Anything else? Green flame blade. You did two more damage.
Green flame.
Two more damage.
All right.
Then, as a bonus action, I'm going to swing around my other sword and hit wolf number 3.
Now you're pissing 2 off at a time. You got balls, bud.
Okay, and the bonus, how does the bonus action work? I don't get plus 5 on it, do I?
Corv, thanks so much for the follow.
Yeah, yes.
You should have on your sheet, you should have an offhand attack, right? Let's go to your actions.
Oh, yeah, I see it.
Offhands, offhand. There it is. Yep, there
that says bludgeoning, though.
Because it's unarmed.
Okay. Unarmed, yeah.
Yeah. All right. That is a hit also on wolf number 3. Nice one. Or wolf number 1, I think. All right, so are you attacking 3 or 1? You said you were going to attack 3, but you attacked 1. You just want to keep it on wolf 1?
Still has wolf 1 targeted.
Yeah. Varys, you want to...
Yeah, just leave it on wolf 1.
Okay. All right, sounds good. Anything else for you? Any you want to run away and take 2 attacks of opportunity? I'd love to give them to you.
No. No.
All right.
Do not have evasion or disengage yet, so no.
All right. Let's go to Omi. Yeah, 2 streams, Dev. 1 for my patrons,
right,
1
I'm
for
move up to
the
here.
Twitch channel. Subscribers to the Twitch channel will get some different prizes as well. All right. I approve that move.
And I'm going to put my hand on Markesh's back and cast Cure Wounds on him.
God, if I only had a 15-foot cone, I could fuck all you guys up at once. The dire wolf breathes fire. Just kidding.
Turns out it's
you're a monster. You can do what you want.
Dave, I'm looking in the monster manual, and these dire wolves do not have a flame breath. I'm looking at it right now. Oh, I've heard it. Believe me.
It's a half wolf, dire wolf, and half hellhound.
Oh, yes.
And then I'm gonna turn to Kel and say, "Nice shot. Do it again, Kel. I know you can do it." As I give him bardic inspiration again.
A bard that uses bardic inspiration. I love this. I had a bard in my first game ever and used inspiration twice in like 2 years of playing. Or like a year, I would say at least a year. Oh, man. Yeah, that's okay. All right, so let's see. You hit a heal. I like it. Very nice. Markish, top of the round. Third round. Let's do it.
All right, so seeing the massive amount of damage we were able to, well, that Kel was able to inflict on the direwolf to my right, I'll notice that fighting two would be better than fighting three, and give direwolf to my right a swing on the battle axe.
Yeah, he's definitely heavily wounded. Much more than the other direwolf in front of you to your left. Nice hit with a 16. God, I love that new font. All right, wow. Nice. Wow. That was really nice.
With that battle axe, I plant with right square in the middle of his head as he drops to the ground.
Yeah, where'd you hit him?
Shirk it out of the head and turn to my left. All right. Facing direwolf one.
Wolf two dies, goes down immediately. You got to put your foot down on his head and rip the axe out of the head. Blood squirts everywhere. Good hit. Anything else for you, Markish?
Nope, that should do.
All right. Let's move it to Shen. You're up.
Shen will cast Sacred Flame on the direwolf one.
All right, if you guys are going to move through this blood stain. Double movement, or plus one. So, all right. Go ahead and let's see what you're doing here.
Shin has no desire to get close to the teeth.
I don't blame you. Hey, nice. It failed its dexterity saving throw for Sacred Flame, so you may roll damage, sir. Does 2 damage to the wolf. As your radiant weapon smashes down from the cloudy heavens, boom, right into the direwolf. It yelps. Anything else for you, Shen?
Nope, that's it.
Hey, Dave, before you go any further,
sure.
Do you know, if you can go back and look at my tech, do you know why it rolled critical hit? Maybe it would have died anyway, but I just... It's showing on here that it was a critical hit when I rolled a 16. So I don't.
Oh yeah, you're right.
It could have been.
Yeah, I'm not
had
quite
a critical
used to
in
the
queue.
I think you could have
previous time. It's rolled from that one.
That was that last thing that you had given me, Dave, when you rolled for me. I think.
That could be it. I think they were having some problems.
It's the only
with
time
the critical.
I've gotten a critical.
Yeah, I think they were having some. I'm still getting used to this font.
It was a strength save.
Yeah,
and you rolled a 20.
That's no problem.
I don't think it should have been a critical.
We'll
one.
Go
I don't
with
know
it.
How many health points he had and all that stuff, but I just thought I'd say something.
We'll go with it. We'll just make you miss automatically next time to make up for it. No, I'm just kidding. Let's go to the direwolf. Gonna attack Varus. Varus, let's see if you can take a couple more attacks this time. First attack from direwolf number 3 is a miss. Let's go to direwolf number 1. Let's have Varus. Let's see how your fate tempts it.
Dave speaking.
The next attack for direwolf number 1. Let's go ahead and move it over to. Let's let Varus. We're gonna let you hold your own fate in your hand. So roll a d4, and 1 to 2 will be an attack on you. 3 to 4 will be an attack on Mark. So we'll roll the d. I'll let you roll the d4 to see who the wolf attacks because you've both pounded it. So, all right, Varus, it's going to attack you.
All protection.
All right. It doesn't matter. It can't get any lower than that. So that's a critical miss. That's even without disadvantage.
And the wolf falls down prone.
The wolf does not fall down prone, but yet it'll now breathe cone of fire on you. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, gosh, Varus. It's not officially a game until you go down. You know that, right?
Yep.
Kalash, you're up now, bud.
Okay. Seeing that my target's gone down, I'm going to step forward one space to there.
Sure thing.
I'm going to use my bonus action and transfer my hex to Direwolf 1.
Nice job.
And then I'm going to...
You guys have inspiration too, just letting you know. You
yeah,
couple
I'm going to swap...
Couple.
I'm going to swap out my shield for my Axe of Impulter. And I'm going to take a initial swing with my Warhammer and then do an offhand swing with the axe afterwards. Okay. But I'm going to take the attack with the Warhammer with inspiration.
Okay. And that'll be your first attack, right?
That'll be my first attack, yeah.
All right. Nice, 23. That's a hit. Let's see what damage you do on the wolf. Very nice. With Hex, 11 damage. The wolf is in bad shape. It's got several large wounds opened up on it now. You can actually see some of the cartilage now. It's kind of attached to his ribs and whatnot. Huge slashes on its side.
And
very heavily damaged.
I'm going to follow up with the silver hand axe, the axe wound bolter, into the side.
Nice. That's another 23 as a hit. Roll damage, sir. Holy shit. 10 more damage. Man, that was to the first wolf. So it's on its last leg now. Just
now
about.
It's to Varys.
Yeah, you've actually hit that thing so hard. One of its legs is kind of like it's broken, and it's kind of just limping around as it's kind of like walking on its like joint, and the rest of his foot is broke. He's kind of hobbling around, yelping. Varys, what say you? Yep, 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 yep.
Okay. I am going to swing on the wolf number one with the short sword. Then I'm going to do a bonus attack on dire wolf number three. One is already targeted.
11 with your bless is a miss.
And so I don't get the bonus attack because I missed,
sure.
Right?
No, sure. You can still take it. Yeah, as long as you take the attack action. Yeah, as long as you take the attack, you get another. You get another hit with your offhand, whether you hit or not. So.
Well, seeing that I missed number one, I'll do the unarmed attack on him again.
Okay, go for it. Good to see you, Schmo. Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! Now you hit that time. You did one damage. The damn thing had two life left.
Aw, man.
All right, Omi, what say you?
Omi is going to...
sneeze on it.
I moved the marker there a little bit too far.
He's gonna sneak and get that kill. That's what he wants.
I totally didn't mean to do that.
I'm gonna try to take this one out. That looks like it's really badly hurt. Attack it with my short sword.
Okay.
Kill stealer.
That's
nope,
a miss.
That's a bad miss.
That's
and
a
I'll
real
say,
bad miss.
I couldn't get it, Markish. You get it as I give Markish bardic inspiration.
Anything else for you, Mr. Omi?
That'll do it.
All right, let's go to round four. Markish, you're up again.
Heeding the words of the wonderful bard Omi, even though he has those goddamn spoons, I will see if I can't dispatch the wolf in front of me.
Oh,
that's
nice.
A true crit. Thank you. Thank you.
I want to see the damage.
I'm going to lop this thing's head off and mount it.
Yeah. It is definitely dead. That's for sure.
Battle Axe has taken a nice looking head mount that I may strap to the back of a horse here in a sec. As he goes down, I am going to take some movement. It's going to be double movement, I believe, to walk through him. So I'll move one north and then one so that I'm adjacent to Varys and that last direwolf.
There?
Thank you. Yep, perfect.
Yep, got it.
And that will take my turn.
What's up, BZ? Good to see you, BZ. All right.
Shen apologizes for his scheduled move. And we'll cast Sacred Flame on the remaining direwolf.
Okay, that sounds good. It is a successful dexterity saving throw.
This fur must be wet.
It is. I'd blame it on the rain too. Blame it on the rain. Yeah. Wow. I didn't even lip sync that. I thought that sounded pretty goddamn good. Anything else for you, Shen? Any bonus action? Any other movement you want to take? Anything?
Yeah, I would like to move out of the slickery spot.
All right. Go ahead and where you want to move?
Right there.
Oh. Right here?
No. Right. One more down this way.
All right. Gotcha.
Stay away from the teeth.
I gotcha. All right. Direwolf. I got three targets to choose from. Let's let Kellish. Kel, you go ahead and give me a D6. 1, 2, Mark. 3, 4, Varus. 5, 6. Yeah, hey. The roller, you can't complain when I take you out with a crit.
Oh, I'm gonna use
protection. Oh my god! No. Okay, you're so lucky.
I was gonna drop the effect on him, but
it's not a problem. That's not a problem. Even though you just shattered my dreams of taking someone
Thank
out.
God.
Wow, yes! Look at that. I got both a crit hit and a critness. Yeah, I know. My
Thank
life
you for that,
story.
Rakesh. You just saw the life flash before my eyes.
Rash, thanks so much for following.
An inch from your neck.
Thank you so much, Rashel.
And then his paws slipped
my
and
life
went
story.
Face first, like Varus did, pushing the cart.
We'll say yes. We'll do that. No.
I joke and say, hey, Varus, that wolf looks like you, full of mud on the face.
You guys are already 5-on-1, so. All right, let's get this thing killed. Kellash, you're up now.
After leaning back and just missing the teeth biting into me, I'm gonna retort with using my bonus action to hex it back. And
you're gonna say, "G'day, bitch!" Hex.
And then I'm gonna try and uppercut it with my warhammer while it's trying to recoil from trying to bite me.
I had to say that. Nice hit.
Damage, and then I'm gonna offhand with the axe.
Well, you guys are rolling great tonight.
And that's all me.
Right, I don't feel bad later, protection only works if the person I'm protecting is within 5 feet of me.
Within 5 feet, correct.
Mm-hmm. And yep. he wasn't within 5 feet of me.
You're right, yeah. You're right. That was my move. I should have been on top of that.
Yeah. Do you want to roll damage, Dave? I don't
mind. You've already rolled damage, haven't you? Twice?
Yeah, no. Do you want to roll damage for yours?
No. I should have caught it.
That's right, Cuddy.
Yeah. No, I'm not going to roll damage. I should have caught it. So, yeah, just make sure it's. I was thinking you were beside him. I'm still not 100%, so go for it.
Okay. Well, I've passed the puck. Nice.
All right, Amy.
All right.
Blame it on the rain. Yeah.
I'll move to right here as I take out my short bow. All right. Try to stick an arrow in this thing.
Hopefully you can. Damn thing's huge.
I think you just got it, Faris.
Nice damage.
Thank God for Bless. We'd suck.
Bless is
you
pretty powerful.
Me.
Varus, what's up? Your turn.
No, he didn't skip you. You tried to hit him.
I did?
Yeah, you took a swing at the guy and then missed him, didn't you? Oh, that was last round.
No, Varus is up.
thought I heard it ding, but the other person was still talking. And then he said, I pass, and then it was like, you skipped me.
No, it's your turn. You should have heard, just heard a ping.
Okay, I didn't hear a ping that time.
I'll ping you a couple times.
All right, so the question is, I can't find any attacks on here, like Fury of Blows.
You hear the pings now?
I can hear them.
I can hear them in the background, too. Ping, ping, ping.
Ping.
So, Flurry of Blows and stuff you're talking about? Flurry of Blows, or...?
Yeah. I'm trying to figure out how to... What... I can use a key point to do a Flurry of Blows.
Yeah. You'll have to look at that, you'll have to look at that monk character sheet after the game tonight. So, if you want to go ahead and... Go ahead.
Okay, just regular attack.
No, you can spend. No, you can spend a key. We'll just keep track of it. Man, how many do you have? Like two? Two or three? Level one? Level three?
Two, I think.
Yeah,
it's two.
After the game, we'll check out the level 20 monk sheet for you, and then you can take all of those actions and just kind of copy, drag and drop them onto your character sheet, basically. In fact, we could do that now. Hold on 1 second. Stand by.
Well, I don't want to hold up the game doing this.
It's all right. Go ahead and do what you're going to do. What, are you going to attack something?
Yeah, I'm going to just attack the... I'll just use the regular attack on the wolf.
Okay.
And the unarmed attack like I've been doing.
So all it's going to do, you're going to do what? Flurry of Blows? All right, so your first attack is a hit. Go ahead and roll damage on the wolf. And then you'll lose a key point, and you'll get two unarmed attacks now. Very nice. 8 damage with the short sword. Now go ahead and do your first unarmed attack from using Flurry of Blows. All right, that one was a miss. Now go ahead and do your second one with Flurry of Blows. That one is a hit. So now you can go ahead and roll your unarmed damage, which is going to be 4 more to wolf number 3. So, oh, it's in bad shape now. It's got a little bit of life left. It's got a couple of wounds now. Side of its head kind of caved in from the flurry of blows. And now it is to the top of the order and Markish. Unless you want to do it, is there any other movement you want to take or anything, Varish? Anything? I don't think you got really anything else, do you? All right. We'll go to Markish. You're up.
Just in the off chance that the group doesn't dispatch this, I'm going to shimmy around him, not out of his sphere of influence, though. I'll track where I move.
Okay.
And that should be 30. I just want to be within 5 feet of both those guys, and I will take my attack with my battle axe.
So you run circles around him and then smack him with your axe as he's distracted.
That's the great thing about 5e. You can run circles around something all day long. Just don't leave its range, its reach. Alright, so...
It's still doing crit.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe it was with that blast or something.
Take a look at it. Something's amiss. We'll take a look at it though after the game. So, all right, Direwolf goes
on
down.
19 or 20?
I don't think he's
not yet
a champion. So,
nope.
No. All right, there we go. Wolf is dead. You guys are out of combat. It was inevitable that thing was going to die anyway. Oh, so you guys are out of combat, and you can go
chase it after our horses.
Yes, you can go ahead and close the map. So, the wolf pups, you can still hear them kind of yipping behind one of the bushes. But all three.
Maybe
of
we should
the,
get one for. Maybe we should pick one up for Yip. Take it back as a present.
Take it back to Yip. Yip.
Yeah,
yip,
I'd like
yip
to see if I can use animal handling to see if I can get one of these wolf pups to come in and maybe befriend it.
I think you should take them all, but we should sell them.
A direwolf? Yeah, they're pretty big difference between a wolf and a direwolf, though. It would take quite a bit of handling to get that dire wolf to appreciate you. But yeah, if you want to try, go for it. I'm totally up for it.
What do you name them? Stains?
No, come Stains. Come Stains. Come Stains.
I'd have to name him Mojo, because he would be my Mojo.
Amex so, Stace.
Animal handling check.
Thanks for the follow. Cussing Demon, thanks for the follow. That is correct. Corvette, thanks for the follow. And Rashiel, thanks for the follow. Nice animal check. Well, they 21. So you can get one of the wolves for now to kind of take to you for a little bit.
Nice.
All right.
So what else is everyone doing? There's a total of 3 of these dire wolves. So
yeah, I'd like for Shen to get me one too.
To where you can kind of like pick them up, maybe, and tell me what you're doing during this animal handling, Shen. Just not with a roll up there. What are you doing when you're doing that?
Well, I'm kind of squatting down, trying to call them in. Maybe have some meat out for them to entice them to come in.
You're gonna feed them the other
Let me touch them.
Awesome rations.
Yeah, awesome rations.
Yeah,
I will assist him in cutting the chunks of meat off of one of the dead dire wolves and skinning, so he has some meat to entice them in.
All right. Well, he's able to get one of them. The other two are still kind of running from you guys, but you're able
to try to
They're just pups.
Entice one of the other ones. And see if we can get another one to come in.
I would say no for you, Kel.
Yeah, I didn't think I would. It's a long shot.
Yep.
And I've got to try.
Go for it.
I'm going to use my rope. I'm going to take the chunk of that meat and put it down. I've got 100 foot of rope, which I'm going to tie into a circle around, and as soon as one is looking as though it's coming up to snatch the meat, I will pull and see if I can't ensnare it at least.
All right.
So we'll do animal handling.
Sounds very good. Ooh, very bad.
And it sucks. That's what I was hoping. I was hoping my trickery would get me out of having to use animal handling.
Yeah, I think thinks that you're going to eat it or something.
I'm going to go ahead and try it. I'm going to walk out there like Crocodile Dundee, hold my fingers out, and make a humming noise, and see if I can calm it down to come to me.
All right. That's pretty wound up now. You get it calmed down, though. You get one of the other ones. I'm going for DC 20. They are dire wolves, so...
Yeah, don't blame you.
Yeah, you can get one calmed down, so you have one in your possession as well. You're kind of holding it and whatnot. It's definitely shaking and scared and... All right, so that's... I think everybody's gone, or let's see. Who hasn't gone yet? Looks like... Omi, you haven't gone. You want to try to tame that last one?
Nah, I don't think I want anything to do with them. But I will throw another Cure Wounds Markesh's way, since I see he's still bleeding a little bit.
Okay.
Merely a flesh wound.
Tis not but a flesh wound. Nice.
Damn good heal.
Yeah, very nice.
Thank you.
Yeah, by this time, you guys get to... You guys let that last dire wolf off. Let him fend for itself.
That dire wolf, he ticked me off. I swore it at him and then started walking south looking for my horse.
Put a boot in his ass. Yeah, you find it about a half mile down the road or so. Both you and Omi, you find your horses.
I get mine relatively close because I didn't smack mine to run off. So it should be relatively close still.
Yeah, so the sun is starting to go down now, and you know that this next town is going to be attacked the next night. Tomorrow night. So, you guys, the sun is starting to go down now, and you guys want to go ahead and break camp. It'd probably be a good thing to do that here.
Yeah, we got plenty of meat for a fire. We can take off to the side and cook. I'm up for some meat for supper.
Yeah, that sounds good to me.
All right. Well, let's go ahead and take a 5-minute break. You guys can take a long rest throughout the night. We'll do an encounter roll when we get back, and we'll see if you guys get a long rest successfully with no encounters.
Okay, cool.
See you.
All right. See you guys in 5. All right, everybody. We'll see you guys in 5. We're going to take a quick bio and drink break. And we'll see you soon. Don't forget tomorrow.
I'll be right back.
Don't forget tomorrow, okay, 10 o'clock. Too. 10 p.m. tomorrow. Fourth
annual. I'm not going to step away, but I'm going to tell you I am because everyone else is.
Don't forget tomorrow, guys, the 4th annual Christmas giveaway extravaganza. Like is on the screen, 10 p.m. D&D books, all kinds of Fantasy Grounds stuff, Kobold Press stuff, Devon Light token packs, all kinds of stuff. So if you're a subscriber, be here. If you're not a subscriber, be here. Got tons of Steam games for... Hopefully everybody will walk away with something. So if you're one of my patrons, I appreciate my patron support. I have a giveaway extravaganza for you guys, too, at 8 p.m. And I'll get that link out to all of you guys tomorrow at about 7:30. And then that'll be from about 8 o'clock to about 9. And then at 10 o'clock, we'll be doing the Twitch giveaway. So, all right, guys, be back in a couple. Thank you guys so much for watching. And get up, stretch, get a drink, get a bio. We'll see you right back in a few. Alright, so let's see. You guys have broke camp. You have a couple of these wolves in your possession. So let's
go ahead. I'd like to take the head that I chopped off of that dire wolf. I'd like to take some rope, tie it to my horse so that I can bring it back to town.
Oh yeah, for proof.
Kind of Witcher style. You know, hook through it, kind of sit next to my horse.
Hook through the eyeball. No, very nice. So yeah, now that you guys have broken camp, the sun is down now. You guys are sitting around the campfire. Rain is still pelting away on you. You can still hear the thunder. You can see the lightning. Everything is just absolutely soaked. You're soaked. Everything. Let's see that encounter roll. Throw it in the dice.
Right, you want a D20, right?
D20. Yep.
All right, I'll throw it.
And it's at night. You are lucky, good sir, because I was going to do 15 to 20. You had an encounter, but no, you didn't.
I was looking for an encounter.
I know, you probably were. All right, but nothing happens. You know, all of your watches are uneventful. What's going to happen during this camp at night? It's so quiet.
Well, Shin's trying to create a bond with his new direwolf puppy.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a bit of puppy playing with these the two guys with their new puppies. I'm going to have a gentle play on my flute.
They're taking to you guys for now. Sure.
Make sure we give them plenty of meat as we cook some meat on the fire for us. Check some raw meat for them to eat.
All right. Omi, what about you?
Omi, seeing how the wolf pup, dire wolf pup responds to some spoons playing.
I don't know how many times I have to tell you, Omi. No one likes spoons.
What? Everybody likes spoons.
You're gonna get kicked out of the bar just like you did back in Flan. You've got, even with as much talent as someone might have, no one likes spoons.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Shin's puppy comes over and sits down beside him and kind of looks at me and looks at Omi playing the spoons, looks at me, looks at Omi playing the spoons, looks at me, looks at Omi playing the spoons, kind of, really?
Yeah, it tilts its head. It gives you the ears kind of go up and tilts its head. And you can just, see this meme that says, oh really? O-R-L-Y? Oh really?
I mean my dog spoons. And I say, here, Omi, if you want to play with spoons.
Oh, nice. I like that. I'm going to give you an inspiration for that. I'm going to give you an inspiration for that, Varys. Go ahead. That's a good one. I like that.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'm not going to lie. Marcus is pretty angry he didn't get one at this point, so he's not going to be very kindly to the anything in camp direwolf that isn't belonging to him. And with spoons, it does not make my mood any better.
What kind of name you giving that thing, Shin?
Mojo.
Mojo, all right. Cool name, I like it. What in the hell's a Mojo?
Just wait till he loses his Mojo.
Yeah, right.
I says, my real dog's name is Mojo.
Well, I thought he already, according to the tale, he already lost his Mojo, didn't he?
Yep, so this is replacing him.
Oh, that's so good. All right, so the sun starts to... You can tell the sun comes up as it's really overcast out. Nothing else happens. You guys get a dried sleep for the night. Everything is still soaked as you guys awaken. Still storming. Kind of settles down a little bit. But what say you, hardy adventurers, now that you guys are packed and whatnot, ready to go.
We'll make a station to try and get there ready for the attack this following night.
Yeah, we need to make haste to our destination.
Okay.
Yeah, we're running a bit late. We should have been there by now, so we've spent the day there already, but so not quite there yet, so we need to
make another our day.
First priority.
Another day before the next attack, so you guys are traveling west again.
We can't be far off. Maybe about a quarter of a day off.
Yeah. So is it supposed to happen tonight or tomorrow night? Another day.
At night.
Yep. Should be tonight, right?
Yep.
Yep, we've got to make it to the destination tonight.
Yep. You guys are traveling west along the Iron Road, and as you start to approach, you can see off in the distance, as the road gets really close to the Moon Sea and kind of follows the contour of the lake. You know, and by now, the weather has, it's mid-morning or so, the weather has actually kind of worsened a little bit. And as you are getting closer to what looks like a boat, you actually, you know, through the rain and all of the mist that's still, and the fog and the steam still coming up from the ground, you can actually see an elderly man with a really crazy wild beard, and he has a boat, and he's got, it's a very large flat bottom type of raft, and he's got his, you can see that he has the rope, you know, over his arm, and he's pulling this raft, and it's off into the distance. You can see out in the middle of the water there is a small island, and he, you know, he kind of stops you. He says, "Oh, great weather we're having today, eh?"
Delightful. Rain.
Always rainy.
Ah, the Moon Sea is churning with Umberlee's wrath today, just like the last day yesterday. Are you needing a ride to the village, to the island? I am, even in these horrendous conditions that we are suffering through, I am still available for hire if you'd like to take the raft to this small island and maybe catch a little bit of a dry spell if you'd like. Name's Warsh. Warsh the Boatman. Good to meet ya. And he's got like squinting eye. You know, he's got just water dripping into his eye. His beard is all just soaked.
Is the island?
He's got his eye clenched down. He's got a pipe between his teeth, you know, and he's, what did you say, young man? I'm getting old in my age, and it's harder to heal you. Hear, not heal, but hear you. Come on, speak up. You said something.
Well, my question was to DM, is the island where we want to go?
Maybe. I don't know.
Well, I say, I'm going to look to
Lunas Bloodmoon. Thank you.
I'm going to look to him and say, the attacks haven't been on nothing. I would assume if there's an attack coming, it's going to come from, going to be on a town or at a town.
Yeah, at a village. I would imagine it's more likely to be a village.
Thank you so much for your support, Lunas. Good to see you, man.
So, do we need to take a ride over there?
Attacks! What are you talking about, attacks? Yeah, as he's like clenching his pipe between his teeth and stuff. He's like, what are you talking about?
Rumors on the Iron Road. Attacks and undead and Dracolich. It seems to be an awful lot of talk on it on the road.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you want to go to the island, it's going to be a gold per head and a silver piece for each mount. And you can get over there and you can get dry and whatnot. And I'll tell you what, my family's been around this island for 5 generations. Count that. And he starts putting his fingers out. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 generations, and we ain't seen anything like what you're talking about, attacks and stuff.
Heard of no attacks along the Moon Sea? You've heard no tale of these attacks?
No, not I. No, sir, not for 5 generations.
5, yes, I understand. 5.
Yep.
Has your family always been boatmen?
Of course. Yeah. And this has been the worst storm we've seen in a little while.
Have there been many storms these days?
No, not like this. Just your typical rains, but this has been a pretty angry storm.
What does the storm bring?
Uh, We're all soaked, aren't we? It's bringing a lot of rain.
Brings wet.
Maybe it'll bring some praise for Tiamat. I don't know. It would be nice, though, if it would bring some good tidings to go with Tiamat.
Oh, my ears will perk at that. I'm going to insight check this guy and be a bit wary.
All right.
Concur with that.
We just need to be aware of those sea pirates. They've been around a little while, though. But we've always dealt with the pirates. Sometimes we give them some money.
And ask, do we need to travel there? Do we need to go to the town?
Yeah, you don't need to go. Just go ahead and stay wet. I don't care. It don't bother me one bit or another. I just saw you running down the road, so I figured, hey, maybe you might want some food and shelter. And holy shit, somebody's got some feedback going on there.
What's the name of the town?
There is no... We don't have no name. It's just a village on an island.
Yeah, I think that's going to be where we need to go and have a cruise round.
But didn't the person that told us where to go tell us the name of the town we're supposed to go to?
There wasn't one. He knew that there was a dock there, but he wasn't sure about any town or village.
Well, I think there... Either way, we want to be... out there when happens.
I think that's where we need to be.
Well, come to think about it. Yeah, can you guys turn your headsets on, please? Way too much feedback tonight. Please guess. So the boatman, he says, I think you guys should just go ahead and travel. Just keep traveling. There's really nothing to see on the island. There's no reason to visit. I was thinking maybe I seen you guys traveling at a snow place, slow pace on these wet horses, all drenched. Ah, the hell with it. You guys just go ahead and keep going.
No, Warsh. We likely need access to the city, to the village.
City? It's a town. All right. Are you sure? It's gonna be a gold and a silver per head.
Shim will talk to him to see if he can negotiate a little better price, sailor to sailor.
All right.
He comes back and says it's 2 gold per person.
Yeah, before he goes over there and talks to him, I think I want to pay. A gold and a silver. It shall be. And I'll start walking onto the boat.
Okay.
I give him a gold and 2 silver. I'm paying for my puppy.
Wow.
I'll pass him a gold piece.
Yeah, you a dire wolf. What the hell, boy, do you have a dire wolf for?
Pass him a gold. There you go, good sir. Let's take us over.
Hey, I don't know. Those dire wolves are going to be killing our chickens over there.
Stop talking to him.
He's well trained.
It's just head over now. You've got your money. Let's go. Here's that gold piece I was giving you. Go on, get rowing.
I ain't rowing, I'm pulling the rope. Gosh darn it.
Pull the rope. Get on with it. Stop the yapping. Get a pulling.
Boy, you give me money and you just get really pushy all of a sudden. All right. I'm going. All right, so...
I just kind of overlooked the fact I only paid him a gold and not a gold and silver.
So old man Marsh, he starts, you know, he has this rope, you know, wrapped around his arm. He starts pulling and pulling and pulling.
As we go there, mm-hmm. I'm going to kind of chat him up about this Tiamat comment he made.
Oh, sure. He entertains you as he's pulling. And he says,
Tiamat, I heard you mention, is this village a fan of Tiamat?
Well, of course, young man. I figured everybody in the realm, around this area was. We have been ever since we've been here for 5 generations. We made a pact with Tiamat.
Oh, this pact I have not heard.
Oh, yes. Well, usually we don't tend to outsiders, but... You know, the weather is pretty bad outside. I figured maybe you guys would want a nice day off your feet, maybe. So you guys get over to this small little island village, and as you guys start to unload your horses, you can see that there are actually it looks really dry, because there's just canopies everywhere, and all of these canopies have water runoffs and whatnot, and looks dry. So that's where we're going to end tonight. We're going to end at the village. So we'll start back up in 2 weeks' time. So let's go ahead and divvy out some experience and stuff, shall we?
Yeah, okay, next Tuesday. That was a good session.
All right. Yeah, very good, guys. All right, so let's see. First thing, party sheet. Let's go to really nothing for no treasure tonight. So we're just going to go right to experience points. And tonight's game is part two, On the Road. And this is, like I said, DDEX1-3. I mean, you guys can put this in the log after DDEX1-3. Part two, On the Road. All right. Alright, so I'm going to give you guys a total of 200 experience points again. Very good job, guys. There you go. Everybody's been awarded. Now you guys can actually see in the chat how much XP you get, right? Pretty nice.
Pretty awesome. I must have good eyes, because I could see it before, too. I do like it bigger. But
yeah. No, I mean, I could see it, too. It just makes it a little bit easier on the eyes.
I agree.
Yeah, and Lord Gwydion made this, so thank you, Lord Gwydion, if you're in the channel still. This is an amazing, amazing extension. So, all right, guys, so that's going to be it for tonight. You're also going to get a total of 3 downtime days for tonight. And we will continue in 2 weeks' time. So I hope you guys have a great Christmas. And hopefully I'll see you guys for the Patreon giveaway tomorrow. You guys are going to like what I have. You guys are going to say, holy shit.
Yeah, I'll definitely be hoping to tune in.
Yeah, just remember, on all the physical stuff, just remember you guys got to pay for the shipping. Because
that's fair.
Last time I took a bunch of books down, my post office bill was $500, so I can't do that again. So I'll pay for the books and all that stuff. You guys pay for the shipping. So all right.
And remember, if you don't show up, I get you a present.
That's right, and you gotta be there. So, and I'll, like I said, here in about another half hour or so, check on the Patreon page, and there's going to be right on the main page that image that you saw on the screen. I'm going to have one of those up there, and then about a half an hour, probably about 7:30, 7:45 tomorrow, I'll post the private YouTube link. All right?
Awesome.
So, cool. All right.
Great game day, right,
guys. Yeah. Thanks so much, guys. You guys are awesome. Great. I appreciate you guys. So I'll see you next week if you're playing. So thanks, guys.
Yeah.
All right.
I think I level.
All right, guys. So there we go. That was the game. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for hanging out and watching. I totally appreciate it. Don't forget, tomorrow is my 4th annual Christmas giveaway extravaganza. I've been doing this 4-plus years now on Twitch and YouTube. So every year I like to do a big Christmas giveaway. And I'll put the stream up for you. I'll put the... here we go. Let's put up. Here we go. Tomorrow at 10 p.m. All of my patrons, you guys will get one at 8 p.m. From 8 to about 9. We're going to hang out, talk in the YouTube channel, stuff like that. Then tomorrow at about 10 p.m., I do one every year for the Twitch channel as well. Actually, the one for a patron is, this is their first patron giveaway. And we'll do one tomorrow for you guys as well. I've got some D&D books. I've got Fantasy Grounds stuff. I've got Devon Knight token stuff. Stuff from Kobold Press. Stuff from Limitless Adventures. A ton of Steam games. Hopefully everybody will get something tomorrow. I'm hoping. Usually I give out about 80 to 100 things every year. So, but hope to see you guys there tomorrow. Also, my subscribers in the Twitch channel, I've got some special stuff for you guys as well. So you guys are appreciated also. Right, guys, I totally appreciate you guys too. Alright? Believe me, I appreciate all you guys that support me. Especially now that I'm trying to take this to the next level, I appreciate it. You guys are awesome. You guys can get into these games. So check out my Patreon page. It's down below, guys. It's patreon.com/digitaldungeonmaster if you guys want to get into these Saturday night games. I do these for the Patreon guys every single Friday. Also, I'm looking for at least another player or two for a Saturday night game that I want to start. So if you guys are interested in playing in a full-blown long-term campaign, check out the Patreon page and look for the pledge. That's called Saturday Night Game. And also, you guys can, any pledge at all gets you access to the Discord server that we have. And we have a ton of people in Discord all the time. We always hang out, talk, chat, do all kinds of stuff. So check out the Patreon page, guys. I would love to be able to do this full time. Moto, thank you so much for your follow. I'd love to be able to go into my work and say, hey, guys, I want to go part time. I just want to work one day a week to keep my benefits. And that would be awesome. And I can't do that without the community's help. So if you guys want all these games, tutorials, and content created, I can't do it working a full-time job. It's impossible. So, all right, guys. You guys got any questions or anything like that? You guys know to be here tomorrow at 10 p.m. Eastern. I'll be going till about maybe 11:30, 12 o'clock. Any questions? Pathfinder, good to see you, brother. Good to see you, brother. Do @table_topping if you guys have anything that you need to ask. Rhyme, sorry you won't be here, bud. But have a good Christmas. Eat lots of food. Eat lots of dessert and cupcakes. And have a good holiday, and I'll see you next time I see you, Rhyme. Yeah, Rhyme, also Spoon Man. Every time he starts clicking them spoons together, I keep thinking about Soundgarden. Spoon Man! Pathfinder, it's so good to see you, man. Lunas, it's good to see you too, man. Haven't seen Lunas in a long time. Devert, good to see you too. Spoon Man, come together with your hands. Is it Save Me? Yeah, I'm spending time with my family tomorrow. I've got all my Christmas done, ready to go. And, yeah. I'll be spending it with them tomorrow afternoon. And then we're going to open gifts after I'm done with the stream. Hopefully about midnight or so. Tomorrow's Pathfinder's birthday. Damn. So, I guess you want me to sing happy birthday to you, right, Pathfinder? Oh my gosh, here we go. I do that for everybody. Anybody that tells me it's their birthday. And I don't want you every day coming in here saying, Dave, it's my birthday. Dave, it's ding, 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 it's my birthday. I don't want you guys coming in here doing that. So, all right, Pathfinder. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, my little Pathfinder. Happy birthday to you. So stupid. Deverick, yeah. You don't have Patreon? Patreon is just a website. You can just go there and sign up there, or Amazon. Sure, I don't have an Amazon wish list or anything like that. I have an Amazon affiliate link. Hopefully, you guys buying your Christmas presents use the affiliate link. I know I did. Oh, a nice song there, Deverick. Take this job and shove it. That's what my dad used to listen to in his later years. That's whatever you want to do, Deverick. It's cool, man. Alan Coda, thanks for the nice words, man. Yeah, Lunas, it's been a long while, man. It's been a long while. How's everything going? You need a towel, Pathfinder? Nice. What's up, Dungeon Tomb? No, the game just ended. I'm just promoting my Christmas giveaway extravaganza. That is tomorrow. Nice, Luna. Slow clap. It was horrible, I know. You don't have to tell me. I already know that it was horrible. So I'm going to turn on my webcam. Hey, guys. I usually don't turn on my webcam for these Adventures League games. Plus, I've been sick the past couple of weeks with a bacteria infection in my small intestine. So it hasn't been a very good couple of weeks for me. I've actually been sick as hell. Really sick. That's why I haven't really done a Monday video. I just finally put out a video yesterday, kind of talking about what's going to be happening at the beginning of the year. But I feel a lot better now. Oh my gosh, I feel so much better. I was in so much discomfort at the beginning of the week. I actually had to go get hydrated 3 times. Not fun. Not fun at all. I don't want that. I wouldn't wish that on anybody. That shit is just... And my body's so weak right now. I mean, even for a couple days, my vision was blurry. I mean, I was in bad shape. I was in bad... I really thought I was dying. I was worried. Yeah, I'm taking antibiotics. I got about another 4 days worth of antibiotics, I think. Then I think that's about it. Then I'll go back and get... I got to go back on... I think it's Wednesday? I don't know. They'll call me. Nope. I didn't get any pain medication. He asked me if I wanted... He said, "Do you need some pain medication?" And I said, "No." So I don't do pain medication. Because I've seen what it does to a particular family member of mine, and I don't want that stuff. So is everybody ready for Christmas? Did everybody do their holiday shopping? Is everyone sick of Christmas yet? Of course, Miss Scarlet, you can sit on Santa Dave's lap anytime. You can anytime. Oh my god, I've been drinking because I've been zapped, Bizet. Seriously, Bizet. I've been drinking nothing but Powerade for days. Just to replenish everything out of my body and all these antibiotics and, you know, getting rehydrated with like special... the nurse called it a cocktail. I was like, "Whoa, what are you putting in this thing?" It got me on meds that are making me piss every 15 minutes. When I take these antibiotics, for 4 hours after taking the antibiotics, I mean, I literally have to piss every 15 minutes. It is absolutely horrible. Yeah, I've been drinking a shitload of fluids, man. You better believe it. I drink about 4 of these a day and about 10 glasses of water a day. So I've been drinking a lot of fluids. A lot. I don't think I haven't drank any soda in 2 weeks, which is good. Actually, I had bad caffeine headaches, but I don't have them anymore. Rad, Merry Christmas to you too, man. I'm not scared to say Merry Christmas. I hate political correctness. Merry Christmas, Happy Kwanzaa, Happy or Merry anything you guys celebrate. Let's get out of this bullshit of saying being scared to say Merry Christmas in public places. Fuck all that shit, guys. Seriously, who thought of that bullshit anyway? Merry Christmas, Happy whatever you celebrate. That's what it's all about. Oh, we can't say Merry Christmas. It's going to offend somebody. Oh my God. Let's stop being pussies. Seriously. Let's tell somebody what they celebrate. Happy or Merry whatever you celebrate. Let's stop being scared. Seriously. It's getting goddamn ridiculous. So anybody else, Pathfinder, you need me to send you your email? Pathfinder, you need me to send you my email? I can do that. Nice dragon bait. I need to make a flyer for Omi's performance. I need to make one. Our normal campaigns won't be starting up until January 1st, guys. So we've got about another week and a half. And plus, it's nice that I'm able to kind of rest and relax, because this really did zap me pretty good. My Amazon email. What is my Amazon email? I don't even know what my Amazon email is. You mean the email that's associated with my Amazon account? Is that what you mean? Let me look. Okay. Yeah. Oh, sorry for the burp, guys. Here's my email that's associated to my account. It is dritston@yahoo.com. That's my Amazon email. There you go. I don't mind. How cold is it? You know what, Sly? I'll tell you what. I'm not kidding. It's getting into like the lower to middle 40s at night. Seriously. Last night, I think, was about 48, 49, but it's getting cold, man. It's like, it's getting really cold. It's like the apocalypse. 40 degrees is freezing. 40 degrees is like negative 20 in every other state north of like Georgia. My Amazon banner should work. My Amazon banner should take you here, and it's on my website too. Go to the support link on the. But this is my affiliate link right here. Here you go. Right there. That's what it should say. Let me check the Twitch channel real quick. Maybe it glitched out somehow, Dever. Let me check it. Stand by, everybody. I'm gonna click on this affiliate link down here. Standby. Trying to make it sound official or something. Standby. Roger that. Alright, so here we go. Go into the info tab. Now when I click on Amazon, it takes me right to the affiliate tab. Yeah. That's where you go to do your searches and stuff. Yeah, this is there you go. That's the same thing. I don't know what's going on. I got a hoodie. I got a table topping hoodie that I'll never wear because it's just not cold enough. I mean, even when I go out, like if I go out and get my son or something, and it's 50 degrees, I just wear a shirt. I'm not scared. Yeah, it's been pretty cold lately though. I've been watching because I know some of you guys are in the negatives, and I just kind of, and my windows are open too. No matter if it's 45 degrees outside or 50 degrees outside, my windows are open. It just feels magnificent, guys. It's beautiful. I love it. Bottle number 4 gone today. God, that shit is good, man. God damn, that shit is good. I love that stuff. Really good stuff. Usually drink one of these and then I'll drink 2 big glasses of water. No soda though in 2 weeks. You just smash Pathfinder? Nice. Eat more chicken. Alright guys, well I'm gonna head out of here. Alright. Thank you guys for hanging out. Thanks guys for all the follows. Totally appreciate it. Meadow9100, thanks for the follow. Thanks everybody else for all of the follows. I totally appreciate it, guys. You guys are awesome. A lot of follows tonight. Meadow9100, Rashiel, Corvette Z06. Nerd alert, Dave. Nerd alert. Let's see. Cussing Demon 666. That's a good name. Amic Stace. Thanks, guys. Taking 20. Thanks for the follow. Wow, so many follows. All right, guys. I'm out of here. Don't forget, if you're one of my patrons, I'll see you guys at 8 p.m. tomorrow on our private YouTube channel. And if you're not a patron, I'll see you guys at 10 o'clock p.m. So subscribers, be there, because I've got D&D books for the subscribers. I've got Kobold Press stuff. I've got all kinds of stuff. So subscribers, be there or be square. All right. Patron people, be there or be square. All right. Everybody else, be there or be square. All right. Thanks everybody for hanging out. I appreciate it. You'll find out, Sly, with the first video of the year next year. You gotta wait till next year, though. All right, guys. Have a good one. See you tomorrow. Good night.